Hello, good afternoon, it's Marcus here with you. Well, we have the show all shook up for you now, and there's a lot of variety today, so I hope you enjoy it. We'll start off with the masters of the 60s, and they still went on to produce great music in the 70s in different groups, they were fantastic, still are some of them. Now here we go, let's see what we got here. Oh, sorry, I've hit the wrong button here. I shall get back to it.
Is it working?
It will be. Just gotta. Now, here we go. I think I hit the wrong button.
Oh, right, okay. You need to turn this on, yep. Remember? And
sing that can't be sung. Nothing you can say, but you can learn how to play the game. It's easy. Nothing you can make that can't be made. No one you can save that can't be saved. Nothing you can do, but you can learn how to be you in time.
Love is all you need. 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 Love is all you need.
Well, that was good, wasn't it? I enjoyed that very much. Right. Now, the next one is slightly different, but it's got very good harmonica in it. Yeah, great harmonica. Without further ado, this one will be quick. This is Hey Baby by Bruce Chanel. Listen to the harmonica, it's good. Right. Program, I usually take the opportunity to sometimes tell you a bit about Parkinson's disease, because that's what I've got. I've had it for about 17 years, and it can be quite a challenge, especially for the people that have to look after you. They do a marvellous job. It's an interesting subject too. There's a thing called that you can get called Parkinson's mask, which is really important to know about it. Really useful to know about it, because it can lead to misunderstandings, unintended misunderstandings between people. Basically, it's because you haven't got enough dopamine in your system, and dopamine is a neurotransmitter, which plays an important part in getting the right messages and the full amount of messages and directions from your brain from nerve to nerve. And sometimes you're not getting all the instructions you need because you haven't got enough dopamine in your system. Now, in your face, you have 43 muscles in your face, which you use to express yourself, you know, smiling, so much feedback you give each other through your facial expressions. And you can be sitting there and this Parkinson's mask type of thing can be happening, where your muscles are just tight in your face and not expressing what you're feeling inside in your heart. So you can be sitting there looking extremely serious and really peeved off with someone. And that someone might be someone you really love, and they might get quite annoyed with you or get very confused. It's sad, and it's very important to keep the people that you're with well informed about how you're feeling. so they don't think you're mad with them. Well, it's just you might be feeling really quite normal inside, but you look like you're in a very bad mood with whoever's in the room with you. So, an example of that was the other day I was just sitting down in a bus stop, just waiting for the bus, and I must have looked like I was really, really sad and depressed, and this van came up and parked by the curb, and this guy got out and looked at me and walked away for about a minute, and then came back and came up to me and said, it was very kind of him, he said, "Are you all right?" And I said, "Yeah, I'm fine." He said, "Because you look quite, you look quite sad, just wondering whether you were okay there." And I said, so I told him about Parkinson's mask, and I was feeling fine. And I thanked him for his concern. He said, "Oh, that's all right. I just care for people. It's really nice." He said, "And I have an uncle who has Parkinson's disease, so he was a bit familiar with things, but he thought I was in very, very sad. But I wasn't. I was thinking about quite nice things, and I can't remember what it was. But anyway." Communication so important, and especially when you're giving off completely the wrong idea. So that's Parkinson's mask. Try and practice, if you've got it, try and practice smiling a lot, doing face exercises if you can find it. Anyway, let's go to another song. Oh, you'll like this, Hannah. Hannah's my daughter, and she teaches music, or vocals to be precise. Teaches singing, and a very good singer, and she's up in Auckland, and she appreciates music of other instrumentals as well. She loves good music. Just like I do. And here we go with So Flute by Saint Germain. Go put it on for you. Thank you. So they had a lot of interesting, highly skilled playing in that, didn't they? Very good. Now, what have we got next? And now for something completely different. Klatu. Let's have some Klatu. Haven't had some Klatu for at least a week. So this one is called Around the Universe in 80 Days. It's their stuff is so often sort of fantasy, science fiction fantasy sort of stuff. But it's good. Around the Universe in 80 Days by Klatu. And here we go. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Hello, back again. I hope you enjoyed that one too. Well, next for you we have the nice little jazzy, sort of Latin jazz one. Called, I can't pronounce it, I'm terrible in other languages. I'll try it, Elsa Bronson or something like that. You might got a lot of good percussion in it. It's by Poncho Sanchez, who is the good percussionist. And here we go. Throw it on. I hope you enjoy this.
Thank you.
Right. Well, that was quite smooth. Found myself certainly tapping my feet to that one. Now, here we have one by, real cool one actually, it's really nice, by Pink Floyd. It's called Saint-Tropez, and it's from the album Medal, released in 1971, yeah, it was the next album after this to be produced by them was the hugely popular Dark Side of the Moon. Yes, which was released on 1st of March 1973. Anyway, we'll put on Saint-Tropez in just a minute. Here we go.
As I reach for a peach, slide a ride down behind a sofa in Saint-Tropez. Breaking a stick with a brick on the sand, riding a wave in the wake of an old sedan. Sleeping alone in the drone of the darkness, scratched by the sand that fell from our love. Deep in my dreams and I still hear her calling. If you're alone, I'll come home, home. Backward and homebound, the pigeon, the dove, gone with the wind and the rain on the airplane. Bone in the home with no silver spoon. I'm drinking champagne like a good tycoon. Sooner than wait for a break in the weather, I'll gather my far-flung thoughts together. Speeding away on the wind to a new day. If you're alone, I'll come home, home, home.
Very smooth. Very almost fell asleep. It was so smooth. Nah, never fall asleep to Pink Floyd. Well, probably something badly wrong with you. Yeah. Oh yeah, I might some mention something I read just recently about Parkinson's disease. There's been some very exciting, promising news about how to approach finding a cure for Parkinson's, or at least slowing down the symptoms, they think, quite a bit. This is one of the symptoms, anyway, of you move around, you can move around a fair bit. You have a speech impediment. There's all sorts of wild and wonderful things, symptoms that can afflict you, just challenge you, really. But just keep a positive attitude. That's the best medicine of a lot. But there's this professor in Auckland University has discovered that, cut a long story short, there are some proteins in your body that tend to clump together. And when too many of them start clumping together, they become toxic to the cells around them, or near, and or possibly, and I don't know, but they become toxic and start killing other cells around them, which is not nice. And they eventually make, apparently they start in the nose, and they make their way through to the centre, through to the brain. Probably the centre of the brain, or a little bit lower down at the back. I don't know, I haven't actually been there myself. But, and they start to kill off the cells that are responsible for producing dopamine in your brain, you see. Now, if they could slow down that journey from the nose to, you know, to the where they start killing cells in the brain that are producing dopamine. Because if they could slow that journey down, that'd be good. That would be great. Anything to slow down the onslaught of debilitating symptoms of the disease. So looking quite promising. There's probably still a long way to go. But it's quite a different approach from a lot of the other, up to now, for the last couple of hundred years, they've been treating the symptoms, which is good. I'm very grateful I've been researching and come up with some good medicine that does help you, help some people in different ways, but it's helped me a lot, the medication, so I'm very grateful for it. But if they can find a way which slows the way of treating Parkinson's, which slows the trip of these clumping proteins which kill cells around them, slows the journey down, so that it takes a long time for them to get through to the brain and start causing a tremor and all sorts of things you get. I'm all for it. It'd be great. Just wondering what that camera was. So that's very interesting. It's a new way of looking at it. It explains why I started losing my sense of smell at least several years before I had any other symptoms to do with Parkinson's. So I didn't know I had Parkinson's, and this could have been prior to being diagnosed. I didn't know I had it. I could have had it for at least 5 to 10 years prior to that. So that's interesting. Yeah. It's very common. You can't smell things, your favourite rose or anything like that. Anyway, so that is a very promising, exciting road that I'm travelling down. The professors and medical staff in University of Auckland. We were right up there, you know, with our researchers in New Zealand. We do a lot of very good work. So they tell me. And who am I to say they aren't? Because I don't. I'm very grateful to the medicine that is available to us. We've got Parkinson's. It's great. Great. Now, I'm going to put on for your pleasure a song called Robbery, Assault and Battery. It's a nice little quiet number by Genesis. And this is part of an album called A Trick of the Tail. It was the first album that they put out, Genesis put out after Peter Gabriel, their lead singer, left them. And they all thought, everyone thought, oh, Genesis has had it now, you know. They'll go down the drain now without Peter Gabriel. Well, they brought out this album, A Trick of the Tail, by Genesis in 1976. And Phil Collins, the drummer, was still a drummer, but he now took on the lead vocals role. And it was great. It sounded great. Really good. So we've we'll put on I'll put on a few of tracks from that LP back to back, so to speak. It was sort of, they were starting to move once Phil Collins became the lead vocalist. They were starting to move more in the pop direction, so pop / prog rock. Very good. Anyway, stop rabbiting on, Marcus. We'll play them the music. Here we go. Robbery, Assault and Battery by Genesis.
The streets were deserted, though the police were alerted. They considered the phone call a hoax. Furtively glancing, then jauntily prancing, the youth caught the guards unaware. Slipping between them, he ought to have seen them, the eyes and their owner so near.
I'm only Absurd. far away now.
Hello. I'm sorry, we'll have to hear the rest of that next week. Well, the week after. But be assured you'll hear all the best Genesis from the station. That's good. Hello, thanks for dropping in. Good to see you again. See you later. Bye.